Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the MBA Talent Show. Tonight, we celebrate the class of 2015. Tonight, tonight, both full-time and part-time intakes come together in order to pay tribute to you. And I have to say that while most of us have been busy preparing for finals, the performers you will see tonight have run the extra mile to be here and to attempt to hypnotize you.
We're pleased to put together before you the much-awaited talent show of 2014. We really hope this evening stands as one of your highlights for HEC experience and is etched in your memory for long. We now hand over the mic to Mike and Claudimir, the host for the show. Please sit back and enjoy the evening.
Mike and Claudimir.
Thank you very much for coming. As you know, this is a mandatory credit-bearing event for CMC. Business attire is required, and it looks like most of you followed the rule.
Tonight's theme is... Dare to be happy indeed. It will be a night of daring jokes. It will be a night of daring acts. It will be a night we will dedicate to those we call lovely, our seniors. We are here to present you a presentation and an act that you will remember. And most of all, I think the seniors are here procrastinating for their final presentations. But we have been procrastinating a lot for our finals. So please, professors, take that into account.
Seniors, it's been a privilege and an honor celebrating every week with you at the P bar, the piano bar, that has no piano.
It has been a pleasure partying with you here at HEC Paris in downtown Paris.
If you're wondering what really happened to the piano of the piano bar, it's right here. One of our part-time students stole it about a year ago to practice for tonight.
And if you're wondering about Paris, the last expedition got lost. And right now, all the clubs are kind of cooperating to organize a trek to go discover Paris. The next show that will be coming up is from someone from the part-time MBA. He's been coming all the way from Munich, and he has been preparing specially for this, a maestro, a virtuoso of the piano. Can I ask a warm applause for David Schmidt?
Thank you.
Wow, that does make you silent, doesn't it? Pretty incredible. Yeah. Next.
Our next act, all the way from Moscow.
From Casablanca.
And from New York City.
Right now, here for the first time, the HEC Ballet Troupe is here just for you.
And you. And you.
And you.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. It's a new life for me, yeah. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. It's a new life for me. Ooh, 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 ooh. And I'm feeling good. Fish in the sea, you know how I feel. River running free. Fly out in the sun, you know what I mean, don't you know? Butterflies all having fun, you know what I mean? Sleep in peace when day is done, that's what I mean. And this old world is a new world and a bold world.
All the way from Brussels, the Male Ballet Academy. Wait, no, no, Clodomir, wrong moves. You're not a good dancer.
What do you mean I'm not a good dancer?
You got everything wrong. You don't know what you're doing.
I checked 5 times with Ellen. I definitely...
They don't want to see you dance.
Do you guys want to see me dance? I think if I need some dancing, I'll need some music. Can we have some music?
And it goes a little something like this.
For our next act, we have Dushyant and Dario here to sing a very fond farewell to our seniors.
This song is dedicated to each one of you. So as you take your next steps forward in every endeavor you have here at HEC and beyond, may the angels be with you.
Seniors, we would like to thank you from the deepest of our heart for getting us up so high in the rankings. Fourth in The Economist.
And seniors, I would like to personally apologize because as soon as you leave, I will be bringing them back down to about 14.
The next act that will be coming up is straight from Peru. It's called Toro Mata, which is very related to the bullfights in Spain, which came to South America. It's a long story. I will not spend too much time on it because I think the dance will speak the whole story. Anyway, I would like to ask a warm applause for Vanessa.
Vladimir, it's been a few weeks since I changed my Facebook profile picture.
I noticed.
I think it's time I take a selfie.
I think so too.
No, that doesn't work. That doesn't work.
No. It's dare to be happy, okay? So dare it. Are you ready? Give me some hey!
Come on, better than that. Better than that.
Okay. Let's try this out. When I shout dare, you shout happy, okay? I shout dare, you shout happy. There!
Happy!
There!
Happy!
And now go, eee!
That's awesome. You guys are just seducing me on the spot.
Next up, we have a play by Johan and Birju. Johan is a playwright and a director. He intends to direct a full-length play while he's here at HEC. This tonight is just a taste of what's to come. Please give him a round of applause.
Do you think that I could get some chicky chicky? Maybe get a little finger sticky sticky. You my electrical lip balm flavor. I got to do you till the next song says ya. And can I get a little zip zip? Looky looky.
Ding! Excuse me, is this chair taken?
Sorry.
Is this chair taken?
Actually, I'm waiting for someone.
Oh, thanks anyway.
Yep, sure thing.
Ding! Excuse me, is this chair taken?
Sorry.
Is this chair taken?
Actually, I'm waiting for someone.
Would you mind if I sit here till he or well, she comes?
Well, they do seem to be pretty late.
You never know who you might be turning down.
Sorry, nice try though.
Sure thing. Ding! Excuse me, is this chair taken?
Sorry.
Is this chair taken?
No, it's not.
Would you mind if I sit here?
Yes, I would.
Oh. Ding! Excuse me, is this chair taken?
Sorry.
Is this chair taken?
No, it's not.
Would you mind if I sit here?
Sure, go ahead.
Thanks. Every place else seems to be taken.
Yeah.
A great place for reading.
Totally.
What's the book?
Actually, I'd like to read in quiet if that's okay with you.
Sure thing. Ding! Every place else seems to be taken.
Yeah.
A great place for reading, huh?
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
What's the book?
Key metrics.
Oh, economics.
Ding!
What's the book?
Metric.
Oh, marketing!
Yeah, marketing.
Oh, I love marketing. You know, I read a lot of marketing at college.
Really? Where was college?
Oh, I went to INSEAD.
Ding!
I was lying, never went to college. I just like to party.
Ding! Where was college?
Oh, HEC.
Oh, awesome. So you like marketing?
Oh, you know, I love marketing. I spent a whole winter reading marketing once.
Really? I just started.
I was so excited after reading the first 10 pages of my first marketing book that I went out and bought everything else I could find. All that incredible psychological understanding. Page after page of segmentation, targeting, positioning, communication objectives, pricing strategies, intellectual stimulation. What did you think?
I find it pretty boring.
Bing! What's the book?
Key metrics.
Oh, marketing.
Yeah, marketing. You like marketing?
Oh, I love marketing. I spent all winter reading marketing once.
Really? I just started.
You know, I was so excited after reading the first 10 pages of my first marketing book that I went out and bought everything else I could find.
Aww.
You know, all that incredible psychological understanding.
And that segmentation, targeting, positioning.
Communication objectives, pricing strategies.
The intellectual stimulation.
Absolutely. You never know though, you know. You might not have liked marketing if you had read it earlier.
Yeah, yeah.
You might not have been well ready for it.
Right.
You have to hit these things at the right moment, or it's no good.
That's happened to me before.
It's all in the timing. My name's Joe, by the way.
I'm Bridget.
Hi.
Hi.
Yeah, I thought reading marketing was a great experience.
So cool.
Great. Key metrics! You know, you have to hit these things at the right moment, or it's no good.
Yeah, that's happened to me before.
It's all in the timing. My name's Joe, by the way.
I'm Richard.
Hi.
Hi.
Do you come in here a lot?
Every so often. What about you?
Not as much as I used to, actually. Not so much anymore. You know, before my nervous breakdown.
Ding!
Do you come in here a lot?
Why, yes.
I'm just interested.
Are you actually interested, or are you trying to pick me up?
No, I'm actually interested.
Maybe you're going to try to take me home to show some weird Backstreet Boys collection you have. And then you're going to try to sleep with me, which you won't do very well. And then you're going to get up, go to the bathroom, pee really loudly, go to the kitchen, open up a beer without asking if I want anything. and then you're going to come back and say, hey, I'm kind of in this complicated relationship with this girl called Stephanie, none of which I'm interested in.
Ding!
Do you come in here a lot?
Yeah, every so often. What about you?
I come in here quite a bit, but I don't remember seeing you.
Ah, missed connection.
Different schedules. You know, it's amazing. It's amazing how you can live right next door to someone in the city and never even know.
I know.
City life.
It's crazy.
You know, we probably pass each other in front of the street every day. Yeah. Right in front of this place, probably.
Probably.
You weren't waiting for somebody when I came in here, were you?
Actually, I kind of was.
Oh, boyfriend?
Sort of.
What's a sort of boyfriend?
My husband.
Ding!
You weren't waiting for somebody when I came in here, were you?
Actually, I kind of was.
Oh, boyfriend?
Sort
of. What's a sort of boyfriend?
My lover. Ah, there she comes.
Ding!
You weren't waiting for somebody when I came here, were you?
No, just reading.
Sort of a sad occupation for a, well, Friday night, isn't it? I mean, reading here all by yourself.
Oh, you think so?
Well, sure. I mean, what's a good-looking woman like you doing out alone on a Friday night?
Trying to stay away from lines like that. Well, ding!
You weren't waiting for somebody when I came in here, were you?
No, just reading.
Sort of a sad occupation for a, well, Friday night, isn't it? I mean, reading here all by yourself.
You know, I was trying to think of it as intellectual stimulation with a cup of coffee and great literature.
That only works in Paris. We could hop the late night RERC to Paris. Get on the Concorde, find a cafe.
Actually, I'm a bit short on train fare tonight.
Darn it, so am I.
Hey, I was actually headed to the movies last year. Would you like to come along?
That's a really nice offer, but...
Uh-huh, girlfriend.
Two of them, actually. One of them's pregnant and Stephanie...
Yay! Girlfriend.
No, I don't have any girlfriend. Not if you mean that cash trading bitch I dumped last night.
Girlfriend.
Sort of.
What's a sort of girlfriend?
My mother. You see, I just ended a relationship, actually, of rather long standing. Okay. This is actually my first night out in a very long time. I feel a little bit at sea, to tell you the truth.
You know, at least you didn't come here to talk about some weird political affiliation.
Oh, no. Straight down the ticket, Republican.
Ding.
Straight down the ticket, Democrat?
Ding.
Can I tell you something about politics?
Ding.
I'd like to think of myself as a citizen of the universe.
Ding.
I'm unaffiliated.
Ah, that's a relief. So am I.
I vote my case.
Labels aren't important.
Labels are not important, exactly. I mean, take me, for example. So what if I have a 2-point
Ding.
A 3-point
Ding.
A 4-point in college. Or if I'm an engineer.
Ding.
An economist.
Ding.
Bloody investment banker.
Sure.
You know, I believe a man is what he is.
Ding.
A person is what he is.
Ding.
A person is what he or she is.
Sure. Hey, I was headed to the movies after. Would you like to come along?
That sounds like fun. What's playing?
A couple of really early Woody Allen movies.
Oh, Woody Allen.
You don't like Woody Allen.
No, I mean I like Woody Allen.
But you're not crazy about Woody Allen.
Those early ones kind of get on my nerves.
Ding.
I was just actually going to say that I was heading to the movies in a bit.
The Woody Allen Festival.
Right up the street. Do you like the early ones?
Yes, I love the early ones, and anyone who doesn't is crazy.
How many times have you seen Bananas?
8 times.
12. So you're still interested.
Do you like Nutella crumb cake?
Last night, I went out at 2 a.m. to get one. Did you have an Etch-a-Sketch as a child?
Yes, and did you love Brussels sprouts?
I think they're disgusting.
I think they're disgusting too.
Do you still believe in marriage despite the current sentiments against it?
Yes.
And children?
Yes, two of them. Two
one
girls
and a boy. And will you love me?
Yes.
Will you cherish me forever?
Yes.
One girl with you?
Yes.
Thank you.
Dance is a universal language that sees no boundaries.
Our next act is a blend of Indian Bollywood, of spicy samba, and hip-hop. We present to you Asha Se Masala
Avec Asta.
Asta.
रब ने तो ये तस्वीर बनी आग हवा पानी को मिला सजी हस्ती तेरी विशाल हो कुदरत का तू कमाल हे मनमोहिनी तेरी अदा तुझे जब देख ले तो फिर गटा भर से झर 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 नाचे चमक चमक वो बिजली दीवानी तुझ में है कुदरत सारी खोई कुछ में है कुदरत सारी खोई खोई तुझ में है कुदरत सारी खोई खोई
I'm Jace from the September 2013 intake. I'm now at Georgetown University in Washington, D.C. What amazing years we spent together and the bonds and connections we formed will last for years to come. It's a pity I can't join you guys for the show tonight, but I would definitely be there with you in spirit. Have great fun tonight, and I hope everyone gets their dream jobs. Bye-bye.
This is Ryan in NUS. I hope you have a good time in France and see you next year. Thank you.
My name is Bhutan Zafar and I'm sending you this message from Sydney where I'm doing my exchange studies at ATSM. I had a very good stay at HEC Paris and I enjoyed every moment of it. I wish best of luck to the new intake and best of luck for my colleagues for their jobs and their future careers. Hope to see you soon. Ciao.
Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. This moment to arise. these sunken eyes and learn to see all your lies. You were only waiting for this moment to be free.
Backstage, Clodomir was really excited to see a picture of a Belgian beer up there.
Stella Artois, you saw it?
I think he's sick of the Kronenbourg.
I'm definitely saying you guys have good taste.
Next up, we promised we would have daring stunts. Our first daring stunt of the night. We're going to try to put 18 dancers up on stage, just for you. It's never been done before.
And we dare you not to dance along. Once you'll see those beats, once you'll see those people giving up the best they have, you'll have to strap yourself in your seatbelts not to jump on stage. Have a warm applause for the next act.
JT. Bonsoir, Professor Rosso.
Bonsoir. Bonsoir, good evening.
Comment ça va?
Très bien, merci. Nous pratiquons le français, bien sûr. We are practicing French, by the way.
So if you had one thing your students to remember, what that would be?
That if I meet them in 5 years from now on the street, and if I, before I even shake their hand, I will say, what is the definition of market efficiency? And they'll have to remember. Okay, so I'll tell you now, just this once. It is the present value formula.
What would it be? Well, I think that one thing you should remember, and hopefully they still do remember, is that they have to become friends with the data first. Right? Before you do anything fancy-fancy with stats, become friends with the data. Because garbage in is garbage out. And so if you don't know what's going in and you don't know what's going out, then you cannot use it for decision. The most memorable moment was, I guess, when I walked into the classroom and only half the students were there. And the other half that was not there, was in bed, and the ones that were there didn't look so didn't look so awake nor fit. So it turned out it was after a big party, I guess. And so, you know, they were not too happy being there.
For example, they should remember the shape of the call option. Okay, whenever you see this shape, okay, that's a call option. You should say whenever you have a chance, see call option.
Great. The last question, I guess, for today. What will be your message to the students?
You know, congrats with the graduation. You made it through. It was my pleasure having met you and having taught you. And I hope we'll stay in contact.
What the great baseball player Yogi Berra once said, he said that if you don't know where you're going, be careful. You might not get there. And that's my word of advice to you.
Just one little thing, you'll see the champagne bottle here. I guess you guys will be pulling it open pretty soon as well. Just to say that the current intake gave me this, and I didn't get anything from you guys. It's a little bit of sore point here. But anyway, congratulations, and I hope we'll stay in contact.
You are just out there in the world. I expect you to do a lot of great things, and I wish you best of luck.
Merci beaucoup. Au revoir.
Au revoir.
Bonjour Peter, comment ça va?
Ça va très bien, merci.
Are you ready?
Tonight we have the championship, the world championship of pie eating!
There's gonna be some munching, there's gonna be some crunching. This is a competition that will tumble up your stomachs.
A night you will never forget. A night of blood, of passion.
And of lots of pies.
We have two contestants who have made their way up through the regionals. We're going to introduce them now.
Are you ready to handle this?
Our first contestant. The Brisbane Big Chin. The Kickin' Kangaroo. The Thunder from Down Under. Chris McAvoy, come up here.
Where are you? Ah! Watch that chin and watch how fast he moves that chin up and down. It is, I've never seen before. Can you stop showing your butt and show your chin for a second? Thank you. Our next contestant, the Scandinavian Norder, the Scandinavian Scrunger, the Iceman from the North, we call up Ivan.
The Defiant Giant.
Can the two contestants please come stand here?
Chris, what makes you think you're gonna win?
Practice makes perfect, Mike, in every sport. And this is something I practice on a daily basis.
Scrunger, Scandinavian Iceman, what makes you believe you're gonna make minced meat out of your opponents? Mm. Yeah.
Could you use some words on that one?
Mm. Could you not bite me, neither? Just for the case of making this competition extra challenging.
Seniors?
You don't think you get off this one easily, eh?
It's not enough that we have two of us up here. We need two of you. Raise the lights.
We need two people who are brave enough to battle into this pie-munching pie contest. Which two seniors take up the challenge?
Raise the lights.
Can we ask the lights on the audience?
Come on up.
I think we have a winner over there.
Come on.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Woo. Yeah.
We need one more.
One more.
One more senior.
One more senior to take up the challenge.
Males or females?
Don't be afraid.
Erwin? Erwin, am I hearing Erwin? I think there's no option out of that one.
Hey. Yes! Yes!
Please come on stage.
Can I run through? There's a couple of ground rules. Because this is actually an Australian tradition, so we're not doing, this isn't sweet pies. This is a delightful, peppery steak and mushroom pie that my wife has helped me cook up this evening. And the rules are, I don't want to see pastry on your plate. You're allowed a certain amount of debris. We'll take that into account. But most of it has to go in your mouth, not in your clothes, not in your face. We want to see it in the mouth. You have one bottle of water, which you can use at your discretion in assistance. 3 minutes, the most pie eaten will be the victor. Straightforward.
Vladimir, I think we need someone to judge this to make sure we determine exactly who ate the most pies.
I absolutely agree. Shall we first present the two contestants and then go over the choice of jury?
Absolutely.
So, can we have your name, how many pies you ate in the last competition, and what makes you believe you're going to win?
I've not been in a pie competition before. This is Ashwin.
That'll get you to win. My name is Avek. Haven't been to any competitions.
And one last question. When is the last time you guys ate?
Soon enough.
Yeah, pretty soon enough, yeah, literally.
All right, gentlemen.
Gentlemen,
this is gonna be
take
a competition.
A seat. So, to the question you were mentioning.
I think we should get a judge up here to determine exactly how many pies have been eaten and who has eaten the most.
I think we should have someone who is good in maths, who at least has two PhDs, who probably studied at MIT or something like that. Could we ask someone from the audience who would have all those qualities? So, Professor?
What am I supposed to do? I'm sorry.
That is the...
I'm hungry as well, but you know.
So, the most important task is that you'll have to do your best to try and count how many pies each participant eats.
Okay, that's easy. Easy peasy Japanese, yes, there you go.
And you'll have to watch the time.
Okay.
How much time do we have, Chris?
3 minutes.
3 minutes. Seven pies in 3 minutes. Is that the world record? Okay.
All right, okay, so I'm watching.
Perfect.
All right. I believe our contestants are about ready.
Is the judge ready? Is the judge ready? Professor Rossu? Okay, I just want to know a bit the audience. Can we have the batch 2014 on three giving a cheer for the 2014s?
Batch 2014, are you ready? One, two, three.
...2013s, I think you can do better than that. All right, gentlemen, are you ready?
Open your mouths. Start drooling. And go! Oh, and I see Ivan is already on the screw, he's munching! Ivan is ready for an East Pie, and we see McAvoy. McAvoy halfway through. Mike, how's your side going?
13 is off to a slow start. They're trying, though. They've got spirit, they've got heart, they've got experience.
I see some nervousness. He's actually attacking the Scandinavian scrunger. He's actually slowing down. Oh, no, he's catching up again. He says finished, another one.
Our first pie is down. Our first pie is down. 13 is still working on their first pies. Come on, guys. Eat, eat, eat. I see the end of the table.
He's kind of nervously looking around.
Eat. Come on, 13. You can do better than this. Don't let these upstarts from the new batch beat you.
I see some doubts there in the batch of 2013, and yes, they're catching up again. And they're munching. Can you see those jaws moving? How they move up and down? This is incredible. So heart pumping.
Faster.
Is Chris actually sweating?
It looks like September 13 has decided to just enjoy the meal.
The batch of 2013 still looks very stable, but they're starting to laugh. It's an eating competition, not laughing.
It's not a savoring competition.
Ivan keeps up stably drinking water. It's a pie eating competition.
This isn't the cafeteria. The food is not as good.
Can we not have a chit chat, ladies? Eat.
How much time do we have?
How much time is left? We're on 1:45.
There's still time to catch up, gentlemen. Let's get right in on the action.
More. Let's hear the Australian professional.
All right, come on. Give us your hungry.
A piece of advice, the water is really good, but please don't puke.
You can do better than this. The hopes and dreams of your batch.
The big chin is onto his last cake. Wow. Are we really seeing this?
The kicking kangaroo is kicking.
The kicking kangaroo is punching his opponents in the stomach with big chunks and bites. But the Scandinavian from the north is just unrelentless. Please don't choke. We won't like nobody to
drink some water,
do we? Three, two, one, down!
Judge, can we have a final verdict?
We will need your opinion on this one.
I think it is a clear winner. The Australian is down to the last few crumbs, and the Avon from the north has 1.75 left. Let's see the other how the seniors are doing. Well, it's still I think it's still doing a pretty good job. There's something left for me here. So I'm sorry, your name? Okay, so Rara has 3 pies left, and
Avik
has 3.5 left. So I declare this September intake, or no, I think it's September intake, the winners.
Thank you very much, Judge. Your opinion we saw was neutral and was very efficient. Thank you very much.
Our next act, Professor Rosu, will eat the rest of the pies.
A competition that touches you right away. We would like to ask the winner with, we must say, a slight advantage of professionalism. Let's put that into
account.
Chris.
You just won the competition. What are you going to do next?
Right now, I need to lie down in a horizontal position. And then I think a couple of beers will probably cure everything after that.
How does a victory feel?
It's just another day, you know, another day in the office. Like I said, I've been training for this all my life, as my wife will attest, and I plan to keep training every day hereafter.
If you have kids, what will you do with them?
Well, you can imagine they'll be well fed. competitive eaters, I imagine. And they'll be reared on steak.
Okay, that sounds fantastic.
Thank you, Chris.
We'll see you later on, and I'm looking forward to have some pies later on with you too.
Yeah, there's a few left over, so.
Vladimir, only two seniors participating tonight is not enough.
I don't think so neither.
I think we should go ask them some questions, just to give them a chance to weigh in.
I think we, as September 2014, could learn a bit from the last batch. So are there some people in the audience who would be happy to answer some questions so that September 2014 could get smarter?
Come on, raise your hand. It's easy questions.
They're not that hard.
All right, I'll ask you the first question. What was your favorite P-Bar theme party?
Tell them.
White t-shirt.
Who is the best dressed person in your class?
Wrong intake. We are not at intake.
Best what?
Wrong intake.
Who is the best dressed person in your class?
Come on, don't lie.
We got a joker. What time does the last metro leave from Massi Palazzo?
10:15.
Aha!
We need some more seniors to volunteer. Identify
Please
yourselves.
Stop looking away. We see you.
I see you volunteered someone, so I'll come straight to you. What was your favorite class?
This can be hard, can
All
it?
All of them.
More seniors?
I'm walking up to a few here.
Come on.
They try looking away. What's the difference between a put and a call?
Oh, it's me?
Wrong aisle.
No, I can't tell.
As you're pretty much ready to leave, define leadership. Myself, at least one honest opinion. Okay, Mike, I must say my wisdom has been greatly enhanced, and I'm ready to handle all this.
Well, next up, we have an amazing band. It's a very large group, and, well, they're here to rock you.
Sit. Welcome.
Welcome to Tijuana, baby.
Welcome to Tijuana, tequila, sexo, marihuana.
lleva por la frontera. El viento viene, el viento se va. La muerte viene, la suerte se va por la frontera. La muerte viene, la suerte se va. ¿Cuándo volverá? Por la carretera. Ahí viene el hombre.
Por la carretera.
Por la frontera.
Por la carretera.
Ahí viene el hombre.
Por la carretera.
Ruta Babilón.
Merci.
We have another band coming up. This band also got into INSEAD and also decided to come here instead.
So they decided to call themselves the backup option.
Hello, check, check, mic, testing, check.
Un, deux, trois, quatre, cinq. Forgot.
Oops.
J'oublie. Oh, man. All right, we're the backup option. For reasons best known to the organizers, I don't know, they didn't find anybody else for the slot, I guess. Let me run through our team real quick. That's Johan on vocals, Ryan Howard on bass, Nico Prieto on drums, and Eli Zorba on guitars.
And Abhishek will also be singing. We're gonna attempt to do Californication and...
Kryptonite, so yeah. If you guys wanna clap along, sing
along. Please
sing
along if you like these songs.
Just get up from your seats and come on stage, I don't know, do whatever.
We're starting with Californication.
With Kryptonite.
Cool.
I took a walk around the world to ease my troubled mind. I left my body lying somewhere in the sand of time. I watched the world flow to the dark side of the moon. I feel there's nothing I can do. I watch the world flow to the dark side of the moon. After all I knew had to be something to do with you. I really don't mind what happens now and then, as long as you'll be my friend at the end. If I go crazy, then will you still call me Superman? If I'm alive, well, will you be with my superhuman, my head kryptonite? You call me strong, you call me weak, but still your secrets I will keep. You took for granted all the times I've never let you down. You stumbled in and bumped your head. If not for me, then you'd be dead. I picked you up, put you back on solid ground. If I go crazy, then will you still call me Superman? If I'm alive and well, will you be there holding my hand? I'll keep you by my side with my superhuman, my head kryptonite.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to attempt to do Californication now.
No, we're going to kill it, right?
Sure.
Yeah, sing along if you guys want to. I mean,
the western civilization, the sun.
the band location. It's understood that Hollywood says Californication. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Be a star, Meryl, I'll break the spell of aging. Celebrity skin, is this your chin? Is that why you're waging? Firstborn unicorn, hot cosaquad. Dream of Californication. Dream of Californication.
Zorba.
Destruction leads to a very rough road, but it also breeds creation. And earthquakes are to a golf guitar, they're just another good vibration. Tidal waves couldn't save the world from Californication.
Thank you, guys. Y'all have been amazing. Thank you.
Hey, Summer.
We only have two songs.
Thank you, everyone, for coming. That was our final act. We hope tonight we've entertained you, and especially we hope that tonight we've helped you become better than the average financial journalist.
Ding!
Thank you all for coming. Unfortunately, that was our last act.
Oh, wait. Sorry, it seems we're having one more last act.
We have,
which totally didn't seem with all the people behind.
Lady Gaga wants to play one more set.
Let's give a warm applause for Summer and her band.
Vendredi après-midi. cruiser c'est facile et ça rend les filles discophiles. La main sur le volant, le coude à la portière, sourire et my diamant, petit déhanché du derrière. Sur mon iPhone, voilà que je reçois l'invitation. Vas-y, prends mon stylo. T'as noté le numéro? Allô?
Allô? Ouais.
Direction Malibu par la porte maillot. Ok. C'est comme une évidence, un mouvement qui se danse. Le cruiser c'est facile et simple comme un coup de fil. La main sur le volant, l'oreille au téléphone, sourire et my diamant, petit déhanché du bottom.
Thank you guys very much for coming out. We love you, we appreciate you. Thank you very much. All right.
Can we stay here?
Do we all take a bow? Do we all take a bow? Yeah.
Wow, Mike, that was impressive. Crowd is all awake.
We finally got them interested.
We would like to ask for the last event of tonight, the last two events. We would like to ask the last president of the MBA Council, Kirti, and
Vasilis,
to please come on stage.
You can clap louder than that.
Come closer, please, please, please. Come on stage.
Seriously?
What?
We're in France. You learned nothing from President Sarkozy?
Of course I didn't ever learn anything.
You're supposed to wear flats and I'm supposed to wear the high heels.
Oh. See, I still need to be here. I'm still learning. We are very honored to be here to be presenting the Best Teacher Awards tonight. And to kick us off, please.
Teachers. They mold our minds. It's you now. Teachers, they inspire us. So, for the Best Teacher Award of the fundamental phase, the winner is...
Surprise, surprise.
A teacher Sam would expect. And Sam that wouldn't expect. The winner is Professor Ioannis Drosiou.
Finally, a diploma. Last time I got a coffee mug. Should I just say, you guys rock? I mean, that was amazing. I have to say it was amazing. It's so unbelievable. So who's running this admissions here? The admissions? You decided to spice it up this year, huh? is Ryan for real? I mean, I'm so impressed. This is amazing. So we have Blackbird, you have all the bass guitar. John Lennon and Sting in one. I'm quite impressed, I have to say. I really have no speech prepared, even though I had some suspicion that I will win the award. And even if I did have one, I have to tell you that I'm so impressed with the show tonight that I'm speechless, seriously. I had something prepared, but I just forgot it. So really, you guys rock. Thank you very much.
All right, and the best teacher for the customized face, very honored to call on Mr. Pascal Keery.
Today I received two good news, so I'm happy. The first one this morning when I wake up and look at my emails was an invitation for this evening. So I thank you very much. I thank also God who gave me with this gift. The other good news is for the future. Idest, you may know that from time to time I do lobby former students to give money to the HEC Foundation. And today I learned that one of my target has accepted to give 150,000 euros for the HEC Foundation. I have no doubt whatsoever that in 5 to 10 years you will become my targets. And I will lobby you hard, believe me. Thank you, take care.
Thank you very much. The next one, I don't know who's going to present because it's kind of a tie. So
no. Let's just
you want
split
to do it? Or?
No, let's just split it. You don't want, I don't want.
Okay. So this is a new award this year. We abandoned the most funny and all that. it was funny, but not very thought-provoking, like the next one. This award is the most thought-provoking teacher, and it's a tie. One winner is Anne-Laure Sellier.
Hold on. The other one is Mr. Pascal Keery again. Professor, please come back on.
Thank you.
All right. Okay, wow, this is really interesting. Best teaching style, who do you think? Of course, but no. No, but I'm happy to say Professor Drosiou again. drinking tonight.
It's a good thing I remember what I wanted to say. I wanted to say that it's a good thing that these things are at the end, because it's very difficult to look at you again with the same eyes. Imagine that was at the beginning. I could never look at you and not see you with the guitar in your hands or the drums. And, so it's thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And for the last award, it's not a teaching award, but it's to thank the people that are behind the scenes working to make our experience great. The most outstanding support staff, and the award goes to Celia, Carl Miguel. Now I can do some kissing as well.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Speech.
I don't think I can speak. Too much light. Okay. Well, thank you, everybody. To be honest, you were my first intakes, the September 13 and the January 14. So it's my pleasure. It's an honor, really. So thank you, and all the best to you. Thanks.
I want to thank the September 14 intake for a great talent show. Thank you very much. A warm round of applause.
Next, we would like to call up our cherished Dean Garrett to hand out
Leadership Awards.
Warm round of applause, please.
Thank you very much. Don't worry, I will not dance. I will sing. So you know, it's part of the tradition in the talent show to bestow leadership awards on the graduating class. So Anne is preparing all the awards. So you remember the process. We first came up with a list. Then the students in the graduating class added names on the list. And we had very strange suggestions this year, like, for example, François Hollande was nominated. But we decided not to include him on the list because he already graduated from the school. And then you actually chose the leaders or the leadership awards recipients by rating them on the basis of different criteria. So it's my pleasure and it's a great honor to now nominate the dozen of leaders that we have in the class. Of course, I imagine you have very tough choices to make. It would be great to give the awards to the whole class, but it's impossible, obviously. So this is now the list of winners. So we are going to start with the two students that got the highest scores. And unfortunately, they are not in the room. So the first one here is Prashant Garg. As Prashant couldn't make it today, he sent us a video. So here is Prashant's video.
Honored and touched by this award. I want to say to everyone that my class is the best, brightest, and the most amazing group of people. Being with you has been the best experience of my life, and thank you so much for your friendship. I truly wish I could have been there today with you to celebrate this wonderful journey that we have had together. I congratulate the September 2014 intake for the amazing job that they have done in organizing this event. Well done, guys. My thanks and gratitude to the faculty and administration for their guidance and support. See you soon, and I hope you have a great evening. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Prashant. And now the next is Arthur N. I actually remember Arthur last year giving the talent show to the class. That was also a great moment. So Arthur is not among us. So again, I mean, we have a video from Arthur.
Hello everyone, Arthur here. I'm really sorry not to be with you right now, and I would have preferred to thank you for the leadership award in person. Unfortunately, my exchange program is still going on in New York as I speak. I really find hard to believe that the MBA has already come to an end, and it feels like this year and a half literally flashed before my eyes. On the other hand, I feel really good about how much progress I have achieved during this period of time, and I would like to thank you because I believe I owe most of it to you guys. I take this opportunity to let you know that I will be working in New York as of January 2015. Hence, if you pass by New York, well, do not hesitate to give me a call so that we can meet around a drink and chat about all the good times we had during this awesome MBA program. Enjoy your night, take care, and hopefully see you soon.
Congratulations to both of them. And now I will nominate the rest of the list in alphabetic order. So now I please come on stage Xavier Burchell. Xavier has been in particular the president of the Entrepreneurship Club. So Xavier, my warmest congratulations.
Short speech. Anyway, I think it's time for Intech to leave the stage to the next Intech. So I'm just going to thank everybody and say that for me, an important part of this experience is the people you meet here. So it was great to meet you all, and I really thank you for this award. Thank you.
Great. Thank you very much. Next on the list is Erwan Germain. We all remember him on stage last year, and he came again this year in a different cloth, but always extremely elegant. My warmest congratulations, Erwan.
Thank you.
When you are finished. No kiss, thank you. I already had one.
Since nobody's asking for a speech, I'll make one anyways. I actually didn't have one planned. I was hoping this would happen, but I don't have one planned. So if any of you know me, you know that I speak best when it comes from the heart. This last year has been absolutely amazing. Some of you like me, some of you don't. A lot of you see the best in me, others still think I'm a joke, and that's perfectly okay. I think we've all learned something from each other. We've all had a lot of fun, we've had some hard times.
I think it's time to stop this bit.
Either way, the point being, I loved every minute of it, regardless of what I said. I like to think my actions spoke for themselves, and I'm very sad to be leaving all of you. I'm very happy to be seeing the new intake take it over, and I'm gonna leave the microphone now before I start crying.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Congratulations. And now probably a different style with Emily Groffman. Emily definitely had an impact on the class as president of the Net Impact Club. Well, that was an easy one. So, Emily, my warmest congratulations.
Thanks, everyone. It's been an amazing time being here with everyone, and couldn't have done it without everyone's support along the way. So thanks to everyone. It's been fun, and have a good night. Good luck with your future endeavors.
Thank you. And now I am calling on stage Kirti Conero. No need to tell you that Kirti has been the MBA Council president. So, yeah, congratulations, Kirti.
Thank you. All right, I didn't have a speech prepared either, but thank you all. Especially thanks to everyone who worked with me on the council. You guys were so amazing and so helpful. But overall, thanks to the entire class of 2015, seriously rocks. Thank you.
Thank you. And now I'm calling Santosh Krishna Prasad. I had the pleasure to work with Santosh on the CEO series in particular. So Santosh, thank you very much for your contribution to the class. That was a great pleasure to interact with you.
Thank you very much. Special thanks to the September 2014 intake. That was a fantastic performance. I thought we did a very, very good job last year, but this was somewhere else. So thank you very much. Just two things before I go back. I know you're all waiting to get drunk and celebrate, so I'll not take too much time. I would like to congratulate one of our classmates tonight who's become a proud dad today, Mr. Bharat Punati. So it's a... very special day for him. And last but not the least, I believe the best nights are those you cannot remember with the people you cannot forget. So cheers to a drunken blackout tonight. Cheers.
Thank you. Giovanna Santaniello, where are you? Giovanna has been our ambassador's coordinator and also the president of the Women in Leadership Club. So Giovanna, all my congratulations.
Thank you to everyone. I don't know really what to say. I would like to give a special thanks to my team of ambassadors. And it has been a great year, so thank you to all the class of 2015 for their friendship. Thank you.
I think I saw you in the dark, Katrina Sen. Where are you? Katrina is the name of a hurricane, isn't it? On top of this, she was the president of the, or the co-president of the MBAT. So, Katrina, congratulations.
I'm not really sure what to say. With these lights, it's a little bit much. I want to say thank you to our entire class, because this was a real roller coaster of a year. and the most amazing experience I could have ever asked for. And I'd like to make just one little shout out to my partner in crime for the MBAT, Axel, who, without whom I could never, ever have made it through that incredible experience. And my heart goes out to him.
Thank you.
Dominic Taylor. We, the man that we have seen on stage with Jean-Paul Agron, his suit was even better than Jean-Paul Agron's. And again, tonight you are so elegant. So thank you and congratulations.
Thank you, everyone. It's lovely to be back on stage again. It's been a pleasure studying with you. I've learned a lot, and I'm very honored to receive this award. Thank you.
Thank you, Dominic. Yanga Wang. Of course, Yanga organized the Chinese Cultural Week, but he did something much more important, which is that he accepted to come in front of the whole MBA staff to speak about the MBA experience to us. And actually, that was a lot of courage, and that was very interesting to give us the viewpoint of students in front of the whole MBA staff to help us improve what we are doing. So, well, thank you again for that, and it's a very well-deserved prize, so I am so happy to bestow that on you. Congratulations.
I've been thinking what Dean Bernard will say about me, because I'm not taking any positions in any of the councils or other events, but I'm super glad that I've been chosen to be given this award. And but to be honest, I really feel embarrassed, because this is such an honor that I don't think I deserve. There are so many of us that deserve this more than I do. I really didn't think so. And I saw my name in the nomination list. I have been actually asking myself what put me in the list, and I haven't found an answer, but wow. But I think what I know is that without the support of my beautiful and lovely wife, I wouldn't have won this award. So thank you, and I really take this as a gift from you to my wife and me. Thank you so much. And by the way, it's a great show. Thank you for that.
Thank you very much. Jerry Young. Jerry is a part-time student, isn't he? And a student rep also. All my congratulations.
Hey, judging from the applause, the volume of applause, I know you guys don't know me. Okay, so the part-time intake of 2013. We're 18 people. I'm really happy to be receiving this, because this proves that it's not a popularity sort of like contest. Unlike the other people, I do have a speech to give, like about 10 minutes. Okay, so I'm probably one of the oldest students in both the full-time and the part-time intakes, and I'm now working in the venture capital industry after being an R&D engineer for semiconductor and 4 years of entrepreneur my whole life. The one thing that we talk about leaders is that I've often run into entrepreneurs who came in to pitch me and say, you know, they're the leaders and something like that. We think about leaders as the Fortune 500 CEOs, those kind of people. Yeah, 10 minutes. And but usually the entrepreneurs actually, what I consider is that they actually have the most, those that made it actually have the most, because if you're an entrepreneur, you don't have any resource, and you basically have to pull all the strings to make everything work, your vendors and your clients and your employees. So there's only one word I want to give you. Basically, I think leader is not someone who, you know, command a big army already achieved something that is really great, that it is kind of seen for you. Leader is someone who, when you stand up, people will follow you. And I wish all of you become a leader someday.
Thank you.
And as Tony would say, last but definitely not least, Jamil Zakut. No need to introduce Jamil.
Merci.
Bravo.
Merci. They were right about the lights. They're really bright. So first, the people sitting in the front row, thank you guys. We're really grateful for your help. Second, to the people in my class, I was really honored and privileged to have spent all this time with you. I really feel like a better person because of it, so thank you. And to the new class, Godspeed, guys. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
And after so much beauty, after so much marvel, after so many nice things, everything has an end. So we are approaching the end, but there's a lot of people who have been doing a lot of work and have been putting a lot of work into realizing this whole show.
First, we'd like to thank the logistics team who made everything happen backstage.
Could they please come on stage, please, logistics team?
Just take a bow.
Could we give them a warm round of applause?
Stay.
Could we next also, of those who can, of the technicians, they're welcome to come too, if they can move from their positions, of course.
We specifically want to thank Jan, Cedric, and Laurence for all their support.
And we would like to thank two special people who have been putting a lot and a lot of work into realizing this whole project. Could we please ask on stage Kriti and Otman?
It has been a pleasure preparing this show. I would like to thank again Laurence Bricard, Cédric Ribu, Yann Grazio, and Aurélie for their patience. I'd like again to thank the logistics team who allowed us to take this to the next level. I'd like to thank the professors, Ioanni Drossou and Peter Ebes, for their special contribution. I'd like as well to thank Dean Garrett, Tony Summers, Philippe Oyster, Alejandra Servio, and the HEC administration for taking the time to be here tonight. I would like to wish on behalf of the MBA talent show a great success and a great future for the MBA class of 2015.
Of course, not to forget to thank the performers who managed to bear with the erratic schedules that we have, even if we behave like school teachers at points. And they were very, very cooperative. Thank you all for being a part of this evening. We wish you very best in all your future endeavors and all the best.
So we would like now to invite you to join us to continue this beautiful evening for the party. The theme of the After Talent Show party is actually prom night, where there will be a cocktail dinner offered by Dean Garrett.
And a special thanks to Mike and Claudimir for putting up the show so beautifully. And one one more person, Shakti, sitting at the back, who was handling sound. She could not be here, but she was very well a part of this. Thank you, Shakti.